Hey, 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 howdy. What's happening? My name is Nob, ZXPK NOBP, and let's fly this. I have, accidentally deleted my Finland career, so, I'll restart that at some point, but I'm gonna move on to France now. I'll be, aspirant. Oh, the music changed. That means I'm a different team. I'm in the Allies. Alright, so, yeah, the famous Normandie-Niemen squadron. Alright, so I get to fly for the Free France. Turn these off. Turn these off. Padlock. Maybe I'll use that someday. Alright, start this. So, Paris. I mean, I don't know that many cities in France. There's Paris, there's, what's the river? Was it the river Seine? Is it Seine? I don't know. I'll be from the river. From your 4400 BC. No, I can't type in BC. Alright, I'll be from the future. Okay, the famous GC3 Normandie-Niemen. Look them up on Wikipedia or something. Alright, so Yak B1 for the first operation. I've an option. More options. Yak 3 for the Berlin. Ooh, I hate to see Berlin because I think this game crashes somewhere in Berlin. I experienced that when I was doing a German fighter campaign. Anyway, let's fly a different plane here. Yak B1, and then let's fly Yak 9. And instead of Yak 9 here, let's fly Yak 9T, which is a bigger cannon for busting up on opening the tanks. D4. D, I think it gives you more distance, has a bigger fuel tank and whatnot, but we don't care about the distance in this game. Alright, so if you want to read this, pause it. This video is in high definition. Pause it and read it. The Free French, blah blah blah, basically they kicked ass. Alright, if you read it, I'm gonna move on. Next base, the Normandy squadron, blah blah blah. Okay, hope you read it. That's important history. No, it doesn't matter at all in this game. But you are assigned to 1st Escadrille Rouen. Does that mean red or something? I don't know. Commanded by LTC Pierron. Alright. December 27, 1942, 1 p.m. Weather's clear, clouds at 900. Today, a Russian recon plane will photograph important. Okay. At the Uva Rovka. Why? Okay, I guess I'm just helping out the Russians. That's what the Normandie-Niemen did. Just helping out the Russians. So we'll hear both French and Russian. And I'll be flying Yak 1B for the first time ever in my life. I'll figure out this plane. I've been playing this game for almost 10 years, but I never had a chance to fly a Yak. So fly a Yak. Fly a camel and then buffalo and a sheep and anyway, this is the famous Normandie-Niemen skin right here. There's some Russian skin. I'll be this guy. We'll have the markings on. We'll have double stars. Pilot. I'll be a French guy. French number 26. Perfect. So I do have one machine gun. I have one cannon. I think machine guns here and cannons here somewhere. Oh, we find out. But I'll have them converge at 300. This is a fast plane. With a lot of turns, so it'll be a close fight. So I'm set to 300 for both of them. Rockets. I'll set to 300, but I think I do have rockets somewhere. I don't know what rocket delay means. Set that to 5. No. Set that to 8 seconds. Bomb delay and no bombs. Apply. Alright, so back to the mission. Flight at 3000. We're on an escort mission of a recon plane. We're taking off here. Take off to the west, and then we'll head south, and then we'll take some pictures here. We'll go back home. Get this land, the front layout like that. So yeah, it's pretty obvious to me we're gonna take over this land. So there's a two flights of four. I'm the very last guy. Alright, let's fly. So I'm not sure if I'm gonna upload every single mission from now on, because that's way too many. You can get up to 200 missions, and YouTube has 15 minute limit. So sometimes I have to split a video into two or three. So I could potentially have 600 videos just for one campaign. Alright, so I'm the very last guy here with my stupid paint job here. Alright, so this plane does have a fuel mixture. I'm gonna turn it all the way up. This plane does have a radiator. I'm gonna open it all the way up. This plane does have a landing light. That right there, landing light. I'm gonna turn it on. This is a navigation light. Kinda hard to see it when it's so bright, but it's the tip of my wings. They glow, they light up. Alright, it does not have an opening canopy. It does have a propeller pitch. I'm gonna set it to 100. It does have a supercharger. So it's set to 1. And does have flaps to takeoff settings. And then, ignition on. Final. Alright, the Russians are talking. Ignition. Contact. Alright. Now we are idling. Let's go, guys. So I guess, there it is. PE-2, that's a bomber. This big bomber here. I guess here's the recon plane. This mission. It's one pilot, one gunner, and, well, two gunners. There's one inside. Look at here. See, I guess it's the bomber. So a pilot, a bomber, and a gunner. I'm not sure. I guess the bomber's taking the picture. Or maybe they're not even taking pictures, just looking around for the recon. Alright, so it's almost time to take off. So here's my taking off. I believe my takeoff speed is 155. Or maybe it's 165. So I powered up. This plane rolls hard to the right. So I gotta use my rudders to stay on the left. Turn left. I just ran out of. I just ran out of the runway here. Anyway, I'm off the ground. This does have a retractable landing gear. I am doing a horrible job taking off, but I've taken off. This plane is very easy to fly. It does not have a roll trim. It does have a pitch trim and the yaw trim, but it does not have a roll trim, which means my plane will roll to the right, and I have to constantly move my stick to the left to stay, leveled. So I'm off the ground. So I'm gonna raise up my gear. I'm gonna raise up my flaps. And I'm gonna turn off my landing light, which is here. I don't need my navigation light. And my fuel mixture, I'm gonna turn it down to 100. And I'm gonna look for my wing leader, which is Yak number 07. There he is up there. This is the gun sight. Inside the cockpit. It's a huge difference if I turn the light on and if I turn it off. This plane does not have a turbocharger or a turbo booster. It probably has a turbocharger, but it does not have a turbo boost. I think it's just called a booster, but I always call it the turbo. Anyway, it doesn't have it, so no worries. It does have a propeller pitch, which I like. So I think I'm in the flying condition right now. I think if I go above altitude 2,000, I believe above 2,000 meters of altitude, I gotta go to the next stage of my supercharger. So flight altitude here in this mission was set to be 3,000. So I will go to I will be using the second stage supercharger. It looks like all my guys are up very high, so I'm gonna climb up. I'm gonna throttle all the way to 110%. Let's see, which is my. I'm gonna look at my cockpit. I'm not sure which is my RPM indicator. I don't know. Maybe I don't have it, but I'll have to look it up. Anyway, so I'm altitude 1900. Okay. This is my altitude right here. No. This is not my altitude. This is my. What is this? This is per something per minute. So this is my. This is not my altitude. This is my altitude right here. So I'm over 2000. I'm 2100, 2200. So I'm gonna switch my supercharger to second position. Supercharger position number two. And there is no more. There is no position three. There's only two positions. But so what supercharger does? It's the same as cars. It compresses oxygen. So as I climb up high, there's less oxygen. There's fewer oxygen particles. I'm gonna compress more air into the cylinder of the engine. So I compress in more air. So I end up with the same number of particles of oxygen. You know what I'm saying? They're same volume, but the number of particles of oxygen is less dense. It's more scarce, so I gotta compress more in just to get the same amount of oxygen. Anyways, that's my little engineering background thing. Yak number 7 over here. Looks like these guys are circling around. That's my first group, my first flight. They're going straight. I'm gonna cover PE2. We do not see P2. He's just taking off somewhere. Don't get yourself killed, dude. These guys are turning around. I'm supposed to follow them, but I know where they're going, so I'm not gonna follow them. Just gonna head into the sun here. It's nice snowy field. It's 1 p.m. is I think. Anyway, so I'm gonna fly to our destination, and look, this plane does pits down. Yes, my biplane gonna do that. JLA Gladiator, it could not turn pitch down like this. It looks like there's a dot there. It's a dot here. That's gotta be PE2. So we'll be following that guy. We'll probably run into a patrol or interceptor or some kind of fighter plane. That's how usually these missions work. So I'm gonna turn this light off, and I'll be back once we do something. Alright, we're doing something. Well, not much. This my guys are turning left and then to the right, it seems. So we've reached our destination. This P turned around, so I'm gonna turn around with my guys. This cockpit's nice. You can look all around. No wonder Normandie-Niemen is so good.